Victoria Sellers is halfway through her first week of rehab for drug addiction. Life coach Fong Dao encourages clients to seek calm in nature. He believes it can help redress the imbalance created by addiction.
We're gonna head up to the Raven's Eye real quick and we'll chill there.
That hole in the, okay.
After 4 days without drink or drugs, Victoria is feeling distinctly on edge.
Look around you, look where you're at. Appreciate that beauty. It's just a bee. Appreciate the beauty.
Is it gone yet?
It's gone.
Oh my God, I'm scared of them. I have arachnophobia.
Right. She reacted right there.
I know, I should have been like.
So first and foremost, appreciate beauty. I'll look at the dirt and look at the rocks and appreciate the patterns. So the first step is visual. Second is taste and smell. If you guys can taste and smell something, go ahead and do so.
Is it gone?
Yeah, it's just a bee. So I want you guys to all close your eyes right now. You're okay.
Oh, fuck's sake.
I'm sorry.
Okay. I was asleep then.
Conscious of Victoria's difficulty relaxing, Fong wants to give her some extra one-to-one guidance.
So let's just pretend that the wind's talking to you. Listen for it. What I'm mostly known for here is spirituality. What's happiness? What's peace? I can't give them answers. I can help guide them.
I wish I was like him more. I mean, I don't know how he got that. Like, you know, some people are lucky and they get that kind of stuff and some people don't.
That evening, unable to sleep, Victoria is entertaining the night shift with stories and still doesn't appear any calmer.
He was like showing pictures like, this is this hot 45-year-old lady, and then I have the 18-year-old, and he has like these rounds that he does like on a weekly basis,
sure.
and it's better with three, and it's just his whole like, wow, you're right, because I'm thinking about, like, his whole day is about, like, setting up the date and getting that done, and it's kind of like getting your drugs.
Yeah.
I'm like, man, I just can't even fathom that. I'm really nervous about what I'm going to be like next week, some kind of sober, raving lunatic.
Is this behavior caused by the drug withdrawals, or is it the real Victoria starting to emerge?
A lot of Victoria's problems resided is in her emotional state. I think she was using the substances to quell her anxiety.
Despite her struggle, Victoria still plans to leave for Mexico in just over a week. The other clients agree it'd be a mistake.
There's going to be temptation there. I know for myself, if I went to a wedding, I'd just be like, oh, I'd just have one drink, and then that'd be it.
Victoria isn't the only one finding rehab difficult. Her roommate, Rowetta, is struggling to work through some particularly painful memories.
I feel like I need to do like a little one-man show for her.
Despite her own difficulties, Victoria seems to have taken on the role of rehab jester.
Oh, what's that song about the bluebird? Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-day. Rowetta? Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-day.
Is that reference
my
to
my blackness? Oh my, what a wonderful day. Plenty of sunshine she coming my black. Way. Mr. Bluebird, my shoulder. That's supposed to cheer you up.
It is, I'm smiling.
Okay, she's smiling a little bit. Come on, Rowetta, I could be your backup dancer in Manchester.
It is Halloween. Stop it.